I feel Taylor-whelmed is what I feel. Instead of overwhelmed, I feel Taylor-whelmed. I feel like she just like read my journal or something.
You good, bro?
What's up, guys? It's been a minute. I vlogged a couple days of Christmas stuff and then was planning on kind of splitting this into two different videos. I don't even know. Okay, basically Taylor Swift decided to drop another surprise album on us. My soul wasn't ready. My timeline wasn't ready. So I'm condensing these vlogs. It was like a Christmassy vlog that moved into me vlogging yesterday, which was the final walkthrough of my house. And then Evermore got dropped. So I'm putting this intro in because originally this video had nothing to do with Taylor dropping an album. If you want to skip ahead to the Evermore reaction, I'll put a timestamp down below and make it a chapter in the vlog so you can just go there. But if you want to hang out for a few days, then just stick around. Hello, what's up and welcome back. I feel like I haven't vlogged in so long, but I'm excited to be vlogging today. I'm doing Christmas shopping. This year, I'm not doing as much content right now as I usually do. Normally, I'd be cracking out all the Christmas stuff, but I'm currently staying in an Airbnb right now up until I get my new house. And then I'm gonna put up my Christmas tree, but realistically, I have no Christmas decorations here. I have no Christmas tree. Christmas content has not been at a top priority, if you will. I've just been doing other things, which I don't even know. Do you want a life update? I feel like we should just get to the Christmas stuff. So I did my first round of Christmas shopping already online, and my plan today is to finish off the rest of my gifts. So I have a few things so far. So it's actually Friday, December 4th, and tomorrow there's a Christmas dinner in Kingston at my dad's house. I'm not gonna be going to it because I am currently isolating so that I can hang out with my sister and my little niece, Charlie, which has been, I don't even think I've uploaded to this channel since Charlie's been born, have I? My sister had her baby, little baby Charlie. She's my first niece ever, and I am obsessed with her. I recently went to Toronto to swap some stuff in storage, to visit some friends, to just do some things. So I've been quarantining since then so I can see Charlie again. So I'm rocking these black boots. I've been like obsessed with tights lately. These ones have a thing going up the leg. Can you see that? It's kind of beige-ish pea coat. I've had this one for a while. And my blanket scarf that I got in London, and this vegan matinette purse, which has been the best thing I've ever purchased. I got this at the end of October. It's literally the best purse in terms of pockets. Like, I have my phone in my front pocket, and then when you open it, there's just, okay, it's dark in here so you can't really see, but there's so much just organization as opposed to my Stella McCartney purse. This has just been a happier daily purse, you know? Okay, now that we've done an outfit of the day, I really do feel like we're back in our vlogging game. We're back. I kinda wanna get a Starbucks. I've been trying so hard not to drink Starbucks. Compared to the last few months of like bopping around the country and living in Toronto, I was getting Starbucks a lot. But my one Starbucks treat, I feel like because I'm going Christmas shopping, I kinda wanna get it today instead of tomorrow. Why am I stressing about this?
Trying to impress me, pulling out all the stops. Making my dizzy when you tell me what you want. I just wanted you to see me. Never thought you'd notice. Thought that you should know I'm already sold today.
Alright. So that was hella interesting. I'm gonna throw some beats on. I've been obsessed with, have you guys heard the Crazy in Love remix by Beyonce? Such a mood. The bass is what we need. This is gonna serenade us to getting some Starbucks.
I can see you trying, finding ways inside my head. Lost and out of focus, I can hear a word you say.
Oh my god, yes. So damn good.
Thought that you should know I'm already sold, so never let me go.
Okay. what's up? It's now Saturday. I did not get around to wrapping my gifts and such last night, so I'm doing that now. So I picked up some Christmas cards, which I haven't picked up like legitimate Christmas cards in years. And I feel like now that I'm moving on in the adult world, I picked up some Christmas cards and I'm gonna write everybody a little Christmas letter. I also have this journal and it's got really pretty paper in it. And I've been doing this thing lately where I write people letters and then I actually give them the letters, and I feel like it's just been this weirdly therapeutic thing I've been doing to like wind down the year. I was trying to think about what would be a really good Christmas gift this year, and I am struggling because I'm trying not to go out, and so Christmas shopping has just been really difficult this year. Like, a lot of people are getting gift cards and I feel bad because I like to get people personal gifts, and everybody got at least one small personal item, but a lot of the filling in of the gaps is gift cards for me this year. So giving somebody a personalized letter, like an actual piece of paper that you've written something thoughtful to. I actually keep all of my cards and like letters or anything anyone ever has ever written me. That's how I got this tattoo. It's from a while ago, but this is my last name in my papa's handwriting from the last birthday card he sent me. And the only reason I was even able to do this after he passed away was because I keep my cards. I don't know. Weird story time, but I just feel like if you're struggling to think of what to get somebody, but you really want to like get them something meaningful, write them a letter, write them something, like tell them how much they mean to you, tell them what you admire about them above and beyond like material things, you know? Not that there's anything wrong with material things. Like, I love a good mug, a good set of slippers. Everybody's getting slippers this year. I just feel like writing somebody a letter or a Christmas card is such a heartfelt way to say Merry Christmas. And I'm only a few pages away from being done. I'm reading The Highly Sensitive Person right now, and oh my lord, I'm like slowly moving through the last few pages because it is so good. Guys, if you have ever felt like, you know, like you're maybe a little too sensitive for the world, or maybe that you're intuitive but you feel like you're crazy, or you sense the subtle things in life or the subtle patterns in life, or you pick up on other people's emotions, or you're so like sensitive that sometimes you become an introverted hermit because being out in the world just overstimulates you at times, like read The Highly Sensitive Person. I will leave a link to it in the description box. This is not sponsored. This is solely because this book will change your life. I don't think I'm gonna wear makeup today just so I can skip getting ready and just hit the road, because I also need to stop by my sister's, pick up her gifts. We're just gonna hang out today. Y'all know the drill. Proud of myself for getting a mint tea today. I wasn't craving like a latte or a coffee. I don't know. My body just doesn't crave coffee the way it used to. So it's about an hour and 20 minutes to Kingston, which is also such a nice little switch up from when I used to do this drive from Toronto, because going Toronto to Kingston was like 2.5 or more with traffic, and now like an hour and a half, it just feels like so quick. Okay, the exchange has been done. All those new gifts you see are the gifts for my sister, me, Charlie, and Casey. So I'm gonna bring those back to Ottawa now, hit the road again, and get the vibes going. Saturday, not having a house. Getting my chopsticks because my Thai food has arrived. So I'm moving in the country. I can't get Uber Eats or like anything out there. So this is also gonna be my last dollars being given to Uber Eats. And I have a new Grey's Anatomy episode. Normally when I B-roll with you guys, I like clear off clutter and shit, but boy. I'm currently on my way to my new house. I don't move in yet, unfortunately. I don't move in for another week, but today I'm doing my final walkthrough of the house, and my closing date, it was supposed to be tomorrow, but it just got pushed to next week, which I'm kind of bummed out about a little bit because I was hoping that this was going to be the vlog of moving in. But instead, you know, Taylor Swift, as she does, came in, saved the day, and found out this morning that she's dropping another album tonight called Evermore, and it's like a sister album to Folklore. Also, I'm not paying attention to where I'm going. Okay, I'm good. I figured, you know what? I'm just gonna vlog anyway. We're just gonna hang out anyway, and then listen to Evermore. I'm also gonna give you guys the first peek at my house. So, I haven't really told you guys a whole lot about the house that I bought. I'm actually driving out to it right now. It's a country house. I got country land, and hence why I'm driving on this back road right now, trying to make sure that I'm going the right way. I found it like such, it was so weird. It was so serendipitous how I found this house. And then I was so worried. Like, I did not think I was gonna get this house. Like, I definitely thought it was gonna get taken from me or like something was gonna happen. But lo and behold, it's mine. Like, it's signed, sealed, delivered, done. And it's 10 minutes from my sister's house that's being built right now. So they're moving into their house this upcoming summer 2021, which is amazing. It's like, it's a country house, but it's only 10 minutes from a grocery store. It's 10 minutes from a Starbucks. I hate that I even have to say that, but y'all know you can take the girl out of the city, but you can't take the city out of the girl. There's already like little garden beds that I can't wait for spring to come. There's like, I know where I'm gonna plant sunflowers. Like, it's literally, I'm just so excited. I'm so, so excited. I'm pulling up right now. I'm gonna meet with my real estate agent, and if I can, I'll give you guys some peeks when we do our walkthrough. So it's T-minus 3 hours now until Evermore drops, and I kind of just woke up from a nap. Such an old lady lately, and oh, I just want to sleep, man. Like, I just need to catch up on energy. So I think I'm going to take another cat nap and set my alarm for 12 and put on another episode of Younger. I'm like low-key a little bit just stressed out lately. I feel like I'm burning up a lot of just stressful energy with buying a house. It's a stressful adult thing to do. It's just, it's fun. I'm excited, don't get me wrong, but it has also been extremely stressful. My anxiety has been a little bit more peaked than usual. I feel like I'm a pot that's just been resting on simmer. It's a weird cocktail of feeling really excited and also just like really kind of, I don't know, just it's such a big adult thing. I just feel like I'm doing a big thing by myself. I've been napping when I can because I feel like it helps a lot, just resting. If you guys watched the latest coffee talk or listened to the last podcast episode, I was kind of venting to you guys about how I feel like I'm just like so in my feminine energy right now. Like, I'm just in like full rest mode and recharge mode, and I've been brewing up lots of really good ideas for like codes and work, but I've just been like full up in the rest restore.
2 hours, 20 minutes till Taylor drops. I'm gonna take an hour nap. Just one more hour.
Also, if you guys need a new show to watch, I highly recommend watching Younger. I kind of have just been keeping it on in the background, or like if I need to fall asleep or when I'm taking a nap, I'll throw on an episode. They're only like 20 minutes long and it's such a funny show. And Hilary Duff's in it and it makes me feel like I'm watching an adult Lizzie McGuire, which got canceled.
The name of the game is Mafia. Okay, quick rules refresher. You have all chosen either T for townsperson or M for murderer.
Oh no. I slept 7:30 in the morning. I slept right through it.
Oh my gosh. No, I need to like breathe.
Okay, the coffee is being made. Literally the third Taylor Swift album since 2019. She knew we'd need this.
It's so beautiful.
Willow. Okay, okay. We're just gonna go right in order, just as the queen set it up. I'm nervous. Like, is this the best listening experience? I wanna put my headphones in, but I want you guys to be able to hear it too. My body. Even like the little video. Iconic. Goosebumps. That's the first song. I'm overstimulated this Friday. This is like the best way to spend a morning coffee. Okay, let's do this. Champagne problems. Your mom's ring in your pocket, my picture in your wallet. Your heart was glass, I dropped it. Champagne problems. Oh, this is so beautiful. Who proposed to Taylor and she said no? Who proposed to Taylor? Oh my god. I was not ready for that tea. All right, let's move into Gold Rush. I like this one. Good. What? Oh. Tis the damn season. Oh no. Season. That one was so good. This is Tolerate It. Use my best colors for your portrait. Lay the table with the fancy shit.
shit. Wow, this one's so raw. Well, I need a coffee refill after that one. It's always like the third listen that I feel like really F's me up. So far, 'tis the damn season. I don't know why, like I feel like I wanna name this vlog 'tis the damn season plus Evermore reaction. I also really liked Gold Rush. I like everything so far. Willow. You know how everybody has these like theories that her and Joe are secretly married? Country Taylor. This makes me feel like a teenager again. SD's a friend of mine. Wow. Happiness. Is it gonna be like peace where it's gonna be like an unhappy song or an unpeaceful song about not being peaceful? Sounds melancholy for being happiness. See this for what it is. I was dancing when the music stopped, and in the disbelief I can't face reinvention. I haven't met the new me yet. Oh shit. Damn. Love that line. Yeah. I love that line. Ooh, that sounds so nice. Oh, the guitar riff. Oh, this one sounds so buttery. Yes! So cute! This is such a sister album to Folklore too. Like, they have such... They complement each other. This just sounds so much like old Taylor to me. Not like old Taylor and that, like, just first Taylor, you know? When Taylor first released music, it sounded so much like this. That production level, like, I love the vibe. I love the vibe of this album. Okay, this is Coney Island featuring The National. Ooh. Oh, I like this. Break my soul in two, looking for you, but you're right here. Aw, Tay. Oh, she's got like a really... Pounds my head. What's a lifetime of achievement? Oh, shit. Oh, all these songs are like hauntingly beautiful and complication and confusion and layers of like loving people. She wrote a lot of ballads that are very deep and they're not, it's kind of reminds me of New Year's Day where you don't know if it's fully happy or sad. Oh, all of these songs are bittersweet. They're like that bliss point of being just enough sweet while also having a little bit of salt in the wound. Oh my God. Is she married? Is she married? This song, this album, and Folklore, I feel Taylor-whelmed is what I feel. Oh, the next song is Cowboy Like Me. Bring us some old Taylor. Bring us some old Taylor. Me to dance, but I said dancing is a dangerous game. Oh shit. Like country Taylor, but like wise country Taylor. Oh my god. Oh, that guitar. Yes. Amazing guitar solo. Oh, I just want to dance to this in my new house. In my kitchen, on a sway. 1, 2, 3, we have 4 more. And there's another one by Bonnie Burr. Next is Long Story Short. Okay. Okay, correction. I want to dance in my kitchen to that song. Shit. Okay, last song, Evermore, featuring Bon Iver. I replay my footsteps on each stepping stone, trying to find the one where I went wrong. Writing letters, address to the fire. And I was catching my breath, staring out an open window, catching my death. This song is gonna mess me up. This one's my favorite. Oh, I almost got emotion on that one. Oh, I think Evermore is my favorite. Holy shit, I feel like she just like read my journal or something. Oh my god. Didn't realize how much I needed to just pick up my vlog camera and vlog again until I was editing this. I feel like I've just overcomplicated coming back to filming in my head a bit, but I also feel like, kind of like I mentioned, I've just been in a rest and restore mode, just kind of refill my creative juices. Next week I'm gonna be moving into my house, so I'll be vlogging that too, and just hanging out with you guys on the interweb again, because this was needed. I needed this. I hope this was like an internet hug for you. Anyway, I'm gonna upload this now and make myself some dinner in my giant fluffy robe. I hope you guys enjoyed hanging out, and I'll see all of you guys in the moving vlog, which is hella exciting. Oh my God. We move this week. Deep breath, we're moving fam, get in the car. We're moving and then we're rooting. Are you ready? Cause actually, you know what, no, I am ready.